Okay, so now let's talk about finding the shear stress of your sandwich structural analysis. All right, so if you think about it, this equation, if I'm not wrong, it should be very similar to your equation for your beam in bending, your solid beam. Your solid beam equation is QS over this one. All right, it's your solid beam. This is the solid beam equation that comes from our previous three videos. Alright, which is at 7.3, V7.3, we talk about it, solid beam. Alright, so we use the solid beam as an analogy to come into the sandwich panel so that you can understand things better and helps you to memorize things easier. Alright, and therefore, alright, if they are very similar, you see Q, S, E, and this one. So if I were to expand your D, or your D is actually EI. Alright, so if I were to just use a. So your this thing over here is Q, alright, EI, B, summation S, E. Alright, so if I were to take a look, if this E cancel with this E, what I will have is a Q multiplied by, in case of, instead of summation, we write it as S, and IB. So I have QS over IB, which is the same as this one. Solid beam. So as you can see, they are very closely linked together all in all. Okay? And therefore it is easier for you to memorize also and see a link between them. But it's not as easy as the QS over IB, which is not as easy as this one. Okay? So the shear stress for your so-called sandwich composite is slightly different. Or your Q, same thing is I believe is your force over two. Alright, instead of in maybe in the future if there's any updates, I'll just update over as a comment. Alright, and the summation of S, this is not strain energy. This is f S is your first moment of area. Alright, which we have gone through earlier. Alright, so we have do it for you already. So the summation of SE is all this stuff. Okay, so your SE is this equation, but because there is certain issue with this one. So I will recommend you use this one. It's the same thing but comes from different slides. Alright, this one comes from your actual slide 72. Alright, notes part 2. Alright, while the one that is a bit so-called blurry, alright, is coming from the reading materials. But nonetheless, I believe they are the same because if you think about it, this thing is the same as this. So I believe they multiply these two inside them. Okay. So it's somewhat like this thing divided by 2. So it's C square. Yeah, this thing over here is this one. So I think he make the lecturer make things easier for us to see. But nonetheless, I would recommend this equation more than this. Okay? So this is your EC, alright, your core, alright. And if you so if you want to find your SE, okay? You can just simply apply this formula. Your why you have to determine yourself after I think about it. Because alright, this is the equation the so-called diagram, so I'll just simply copy it and paste it. So it's quite straightforward. Your breadth, your B is given, your T and your D are all given already. Alright. So except your C so except your Y is it's good question. So the y I believe is any location, all right. So the this equation is for shear stress. Sorry, is for shear stress in the face or the core. So for face or core, you definitely use this equation, straightforward, all right. And that it is the y is any location. So your y can be at this point. This is your y, or your y can be at this point. This is your y. Alright, so previously in the previous video on the bending stress, your Y, as I say, is in between is in between this section, alright, is in here. So your Y can be this distance to here. This can be your Y. Nonetheless, your axis can be also here. This can be your Y. Nonetheless, it can also be here. This can be also your, sorry, this can, maybe I should draw properly this one. Alright, exactly. This can be also your Y. Alright, because it's in, your Y is in between the face. Alright, it's in between the face. in between the H2 and the C2, which is this place. So your Y can be lying anywhere over in this line, can also, alright? So this is how you visualize things. So the Y is dependent on the question, or dependent on which Y you choose. Okay, hopefully this is pretty clear. And therefore, coming back here, your Y is also you choose yourself. Okay, it depends on what the question asks you. So you will select your own particular Y. So the shear stress is you just apply what you want, and that's it. Alright, so you just apply your SE. Alright, so therefore, summation of SE is straightforward already. So this is the summation of SE equation. You just need to apply whatever thing. That's all, very straightforward. Alright, well, your D comes from where? Your D comes from here. Alright, you use this equation. It's the same thing, nothing different. Okay? So you just apply only, very super straightforward really, after coming think about it. Then your B is your breadth of your beam, if you were to forgot. Alright, this thing over here, this picture over here is this one, if you were to draw in a long manner. This is the sandwich panel. Alright, so this is your beam, so you apply your force in this thing. Alright, then there will be a certain support over here and here. And then your beam, if you were to look in this view right now, in this view, alright, then you're looking at this thing now, you're looking at your beam right now. Yeah, so this is the force acting on it, and you're gonna bend it, and these things like that. So therefore, this is all the understandings you would want to know for your bending, for your shear stress. Okay, so it's pretty straightforward. Alright, whereas as for the equations to derive them, I think I'll just do it in other videos, so that I'll just not confuse you. And therefore, this is it for the shear stresses part. Alright. So therefore, in the next video, we'll talk about the max diffraction, so that it is pretty so-called neat when you look at the playlist. And therefore, yeah, see you there.